What's good, YouTube? It's your boy RJ back with another video for you guys. And I know you guys been waiting for this vid. You guys been asking for it. You've been really asking for it. Question is, what playbook do you run? Can you teach me that play? What play is that? Like, I get those questions every time when I run in the stream. You guys been asking for the play. I'm about to give you the sauce. I call it the sauce because it's something that I ain't gonna say I created, but I use a lot. I'm not gonna say I'm the only one that uses it. I don't know who else uses it, but I know that it's from the get-go. When I first hopped on the 2K, I looked at the play. I like what I seen, and I've been running it ever since into first quals. So now I'm gonna say this: the reason why I'm dropping the playbook now is because I wanted to hold on to the playbook until first quals was over with, because I know a lot of people have been watching my streams, they're watching my gameplay, they know how I play, they know my plays. So it's like you study the game when you see somebody play doing the same thing over and over and over again. But to help you guys out, I'm going to go ahead and drop the Bucks playbook. Not the full playbook, just the plays that I run out of that playbook that you guys have been attending to and loving seeing. That it helped me go, helped me get my limited games done, helped me get my limited games done easy. I'm explaining to you why I run the play and the players that I run them with and so forth. But before we get into it, that make sure you like, subscribe, comment. I appreciate you guys tuning in, as always, showing the love. Have the notification, turn that bell on, so when we drop the vid, you guys can tune in. If you guys want to know another playbook, like I said, comment down below to let me know what playbook to do next. But mainly, this is the Bucks playbook. I did the Clippers playbook out of a couple players that I did like from there. I don't run it, but I did a couple of plays. Now, this is the Bucks playbook. This is my main playbook, and these are plays that I run, and I'm going to explain why I run them, how I run them, what players I use to run them with, and how I run them and why. So let's go ahead and get into them. So as you can see, my lineup, you know, this is the lineup I went in with Qualls. You know, we got Melo, we got, you know, we've been having Chris Paul from the beginning. We picked up AD, we pulled Joel, and we picked up Isaiah Thomas. So I mean, as far as that, this is my rotation lineup that I went in with Qualls. We didn't qualify, sadly, but we still have three more chances to go to try to qualify, and we're gonna try to push for it to do that. I didn't get a lot of quits as I thought I would, but we did get a decent amount of wins, even though the qualifier started off kind of late. But you know, we was able to get a couple of wins, and we had a tough match that we end up playing. We lost by like six or some, or eight or something like that. But just to being prepared to next time for next quals, we'll be even more ready, you know, and so forth. But the reason as to why I pick my lineup like this for the plays that I run is because I look for big man and a power forward that have brick wall gold. Now, I can't wait till they drop one of them power forwards or centers that can move, that has brick wall Hall of Fame, because the plays are going to get even better. And the reason why I say that is because I'm going to show you as to what I do and as to why I do it. So when I look at my players and centers and power forwards, but the biggest thing is I'm looking for is that gold brick wall, which Embiid does have. So looking here, he does have gold brick wall. Now let's look at his strength, because the strength is what matters behind the brick wall of the, you know, you hitting that screen. He has a 90 strength, which I'm okay with. Same as far as an AD, I know he has gold brick wall. Let's look at his strength. Strength, he's sitting at a 92. So we got two big bodies that's setting some solid screens as to when I'm running my plays and why I'm running my plays. Now, of course, for the play that I run that you guys see a lot, I'm gonna get into that. You see my man's Melo, the shooter, the person that I need to get open and work with, because he is there to shoot the ball, shoot the lights out. He has all the shooting badges. I'm looking to make plays for Melo to get him open as much as possible. ML Carr is just he can shoot the ball, but he's mainly for defense. So he's just sitting in a corner somewhere. He's 6'6", so he can probably set a little screen here and there, but mainly he's just out there on offense just to be there. He can dunk, he can shoot a little bit. So that's good. Chris Paul, as you know, is my playmaker. He can create on offense too, don't get it twisted. He can shoot that ball if I gotta create some action at him, but he is my playmaker. This man with the Hall of Fame, floor general Hall of Fame dimer, and create, you know, he's small, he has defense, he can get loose, but mainly I just utilize Chris Paul at the top of the keys to create the space, try to get the defender to react. And if I can get open shot with him, I'm gonna take open shot. But if I see a pass, you know, Hall of Fame dimer and floor general, that's kicking in heavy. So this is my starting five. I'm going to go ahead into the game. I'm going to show you how it's ran. So I'm going to show you in a domination game so you can kind of see it. That way I'm showing a replay and how I'm running it and why I'm running it. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and probably take a few clips from the streams and show you when I ran the play so I can break it down as to what the defender was doing, because there are multiple action ways of doing the plays that I got to break down as to why I did that. So let's go ahead and get into it. All right, so for my starters, this is the plays that I run. I like to go ISO 5 out, and I like to go fist 5 out. Those are my two 5 out plays that I pick with my starting rotation. Now, the biggest play that you guys have been wanting so bad, you've been asking about so bad, is Punch Iverson Rip. Now, I'm going to explain how this play works and how I get around this play when I actually break down the gameplay against a live person. This is against AI, so you guys can see when I replay it. And then I run Give Elbow Rip Iverson. Those are the two plays that I run with the starters. Now, on my bench, I run Punch Iverson 23, and I just pick like an ISO play. I don't really have that many plays for the bench because they're not going to be in that long. So these are the two plays that I run, and then these are the four plays I run with the starters. So let's go ahead. I'm going to show you a replay. I'm going to run the play live so you guys can see. This is going to be kind of live until we get into breaking down the film. I'm going to pull clips from streams. I'm going to break down the situation as to why I did that. And I mean, I could do it here too, but I wanted to show you guys as to why I did it so people can like see and react off of certain things. So of course, I give it to Chris Paul. We're going to call that Punch Iverson. I love calling it out the gate, which we go to the middle of the court, go left and right, go left and right, go left and right. Watch a player move. He's going to go across two of the screens. Open cross court pass, shoot that shot. That's cash. So I'm gonna replay that for you guys right there so you can kind of see what's going on. So let's go ahead and replay it. We're gonna start over. All right, so we let the players get set up. I like to put the defender in a daze because I can go left right, because he never know which way I'm gonna go. So as soon as I see the small forward about to start moving, I rotate and go his way, because he's gonna go off of the first screen, which is Embiid, 90 strength, kicking in, going across AD, another big body screen, 92 strength with gold brick wall back to back. Open three in the left wing. You got to green that, baby. That's all day. That's an all day shot right there. It is a money play. I'm telling you, for people that are not looking for it and not ready for it, it is a money play. Now, I'm going to say this. There are 3 to 5 plays within this same play. I'm going to be honest with you. There are 3 to 5 plays within this same play. The only reason why I say that, facing the AI, you're not going to get a lot of those plays off because the AI reacts a certain way. But facing a live person, there's a lot of plays I can show you as to why I run them. I might just run an unlimited game just to show you guys how it looks as to why I run it, and just run it live, which would probably be better so you guys can see me breaking it down, which I'm going to actually do instead of just pulling out the clips. But that is the play right there. Punch Iverson Rip. That is the first play of that play. Now I'm going to show you the other play, which is the Give Iverson play. I'm gonna show you that play real quick, because I'm just gonna run them one time and do a replay action. But then when I go into a limited game, I'm gonna show you guys the breakdown of everything within that play so you guys can see. I mean, I could probably make another video to slow it down a little bit better, but I feel like when I show it live, it's better to show it live as I'm doing it in motion, and you guys can like slow it down and kind of see what, or rewind it back. So we're going to run that give elbow Rip Iverson 3, which is pretty much power forward, small forward goes down there. I'm going to go this side right here. All the small forward goes up top of the key. You got to hit that shot, baby, green at the top of the key. So pretty much it's another play set off of a screen. It's another play set off of a screen where we're working with Chris Paul and Melo. Like I said, I like utilizing Melo a lot because he has the shooting badges. So as you can see, pretty much when the plays are happening, we just let him set up. I created the top of the wing, you know, go to my spot that I have to get to. And as I'm going there, Melo is going to start going up as AD is going to set a solid screen. We're going to kick that ball to the top of the key. Melo can shoot from distance, baby. So let that shot ride and let that shot go. And that's cash. Those are the plays that are run. You guys know what 5-out is, so I don't have to show you 5-out. But those are the plays that are run, and you seeing why I run those plays. I'm going to take you in a live game for a little bit, and I'm just going to break down live on the play that I run. The plays that I run, as you see here, I'm going to break down the first option, the second option, the third option, the fourth option, so you guys can see everything. All right, so we're in the game. I'm going to go ahead and select my plays. This is a live breakdown. You guys are getting a live breakdown. I'm going to talk through the plays and as to why I run it, and what do I see on the floor when I'm actually playing in game. So, you know, hopefully he doesn't quit so you guys can get a nice glimpse of what's going on. But if he quits, trust me, this play can make a lot of people quit because they get irritated. You get a lot of complaints as to you're running the same play over and over again. I'm like, bro, get some plays. You feel me? So we're going to go ahead and run these plays. I'm going to break down what's going on in the plays and so forth. Let's get it. I don't got my jerseys to court on. Jeez, I got to change that. I remember I changed it for Qualls for a reason, but it is what it is. All right, so we're going to get the tip off. Give me the ball. Give it to the man right there. All right, CP3. We're going to run punch Iverson rip. So he got Kyrie out there. He ain't going to stop nothing. Another going across some screens. Open pass already. Give me a white. We can hit those. You know, we're going to shoot those. The thing is you have to be comfortable shooting those even if you see him closing out because of dead eye. If you can do that, you'll be fine. Trust me. You will be fine. So let's go ahead and get a stop. We're going to run that play again. I'm going to show you guys a different option in that play as well. That's out of bounds, right? No out of bounds. Good D. Good defense. Good defense. Oh, that's a dottie. That's a dottie, bro. So, okay, Kelly, I see you. Get up. All right. Same play. Punch Iverson rip. Second option. So we're going to do the same thing. This time, we're going to utilize and go across. You get a lot of those personal fouls too. If the player are trying to run through the screens, a lot of personal fouls can happen off the ball. So we're going to run that play again because obviously we drew a foul on them with that. So we're going to run the play, but I'm going to show you the second option. So that was the first option, right? So let's say if I don't see the option with Melo, right? We're going to go ahead, let Melo run it. We're going to cross. The center's not going to help down. That's an easy layup. If the center, if nobody is putting on ball on the center, if they're not switching to the center, go up and get a dunk. The reason why is because the AIs are not reacting to help defense right there. So literally just go on ball. Like just take it to the rim. Take it to the rim. I'm going to show you guys again. If he does not move with the center, we're going to take it again. Same play. Create. That's a charge probably. That's a blocking. Cool. So if he does decide to help with the center, you have that kick out to AD. So, to Embiid, because we're going around the opposite side. So Melo's going right, we're going left. So we're going to do that every single time. And then if he's not going to help up, we're going up. If you have a dunking point guard, it makes life a lot easier. But since Chris Paul can lay up, so we're going to take that side again. Is he going to help? Nope, he's not going to help with Embiid. We're going to go up. Kelly gets the block right there. The only thing right there is that since the shooting guard stays underneath the basket, Kelly can help and rotate as well. So that can be a problem. But we're going to run it again, and we're going to go with the third option. What happens? We're going to pass the ball to Melo this time. So let's run it again. We're going to pass it. Okay, Melo's not open. So now we're going to do is go around. Go all the way around straight to the rim. That should be a bucket though, by the way. Thank you. That should be either the dunk or a bucket. So let's say if he helps with the power forward to try to meet me at the basket, what I would do, that's a good shot, boy. What I would do is I would literally kick out to the three for the power forward. So let's do that play again. We're going to kick it to Melo, go across and watch me get a three with Anthony Davis in the corner. All right, going across. He's looking for Melo. We're going to go right around. Up, he's not gonna help. Kick out. That's a two. That's cash. So I went up. I could have got the easy two with Melo. I could have went and got the easy dunk. But I see he was helping with the powerful with Antoine Jameson. So I decided to go ahead and just kick it out anyway to get a shot with 80. So you guys can see what I was talking about. Let's run that one more time before I get into the give play. So we're gonna run it again. Run it again. Melo's gonna go cross. He gets hit up. I mean, he's open. I'm gonna take a shot. He's open. We're gonna take a shot. That's cash. Personal foul with the three. I take that. Personal foul with the three. That play is a money play. Nobody can read and react on that. If you're good enough to read it, if you're good enough to help on it, you can get some good stops. You don't want to spam the play a lot, but the thing is with running that play, you want to understand what's going on. If they're helping with the power forward, if they're helping with the small forward, or so forth. Because if they do that, you have a lot of kickout options of what you can do. Good D, Chris Paul. Yes, sir. So let's run that play one more time so you guys can see. One more time. Going across. He got hit by a double screen. Opening the left wing. That's a green shot. That's cash. Shoot your shots. So that's punch Iverson rip. For you guys don't know, you guys know what the play is now, so you guys go ahead and enjoy from the Bucks playbook. Punch Iverson rip. Now I'm going to show you guys the give Iverson. It's a simple play. I'm gonna show you a little combo. I call it a combo type of play where you can do two plays in one, right? So let's just say, let's run punch Iverson rip, right? Let's just say if that play doesn't work. All right, so now we, another personal foul. Like I said, that play can cause a lot of personal fouls, bro. It'll piss a lot of people off. Enjoy the punch Iverson rip play. You can get some easy technical foul shots. So before I get into the combo play, let me go ahead and just show you guys the give play. So the give elbow Iverson rip. Give elbow rip Iverson. So let's do that play. We're going to go over here. He's going to roll to the top of the key. We're going to fake like he's going to the paint. Open for a shot. Shoot that all day. I mean, if you get open shot, shoot it. If you don't get the look, don't take the shot. I'm going to show you the second option. But that's pretty much the play right there. If he does get attached to that screen, you can take that shot like it's nothing. Good contest. Rebound. Slow it down. Set my play up. Give elbow. So he's going to the left elbow this time. Let's work it. Going around, go tight. Oh yeah, that's a three ball. That's cash, baby. Makes you kind of go tight around the screen. Don't go wide. Go tight so that way the player can actually hit the screen and he can rotate. Melo can rotate up top. Good D, fellas. Oh, 80's hurt. I'll take a block though. 80's hurt. Let's call a timeout. 80's hurt, but it's all right. We got other players that can come in. 80's hurt, but that's fine. 80's a big solid body that can set the screen. But that is the give elbow rip. That's the main play from give elbow. I'm going to show you the second option out of the give elbow rip play if Melo's not open at the top of the key. So what happens is you can lay the ball up too as Melo's going up the top of the key if it's open. But let's say if we pass it to Melo and the closeout is there, I'm going to show you that option. So here's the second option with the closeout. So they put in Kawhi. So we're going to run give elbow. He's going to come off the screen from Kawhi. So the closeout might not be there. So he's right here. All right. So now we're going to go left. As Chris Paul wraps all the way around, he's going to be open right here. Corner, pocket, three, cash. So as you see, if Melo's not open at the top of the key, even though he was, I could have just shot that shot and been cool. Go the opposite way and let Chris Paul wrap around to the three ball. It'll be there. Good D, Chris Paul. Good defense. Let's run that one more time. Well, shoot, we only got 7 seconds, so we can get the playoff in 7 seconds. Top of the key, three ball, shoot it. Hey, gotta time that. But those are mainly the two plays that I run, as you guys are seeing. You see, we scored 23 points. I could have scored more if I wanted to shoot the ball. I was kind of breaking down the actual plays live for you guys, so you guys can see what's going on. As you can see, why I react a certain way, why I played it a certain way. Like I said, on the punch Iverson, if that play is open on the left side of the opposite wing, kick that ball and get the shot off. If you see that you want to bait him and you want to go to the run with the point guard because he thinks you're going to pass the ball to the left side of the wing, take that layup if he's not going to on ball with the center and drop down and help on defense, because the center's not going to do it. We're going to run it one more time, try to get a layup so I can show. All right, so let's run that give Iverson, that punch Iverson one more time. Punch Iverson. Let's run that play. Let's try to get a layup. Melo's going to go across. Okay, so he went into zone. All right, so I'll make another video explaining how to break the 2-3 zone, how to break the 3-2 zone, and so forth, because he literally just went to zone. That's why the play did not work properly. As you guys can see, space out the floor. All right. He's in the 2-3 zone now. He's in the 2-3 zone because you see everybody set up. So he's in the 2-3 zone. That's how I know that the play is not going to. It can work to some extent, but it's not going to work because he literally went into a 2-3 zone. So I'll make another video that's going to break down how to break the 2-3 zones and the 3-2 zones to give you guys a little bit of help if you guys are having issues with that as well. But in the meantime, between time, I appreciate you guys tuning into the video. This is my main playbook from the Bucks. Since it's going to be season 2, I'm going to be getting into a different playbook because I gave you guys my main sauce. I can't use my main sauce now because I gave you guys a sauce. So you guys enjoy it, utilize it, Tell me what you guys think. Let me know how it's working for you in the games as well. This is next gen, by the way. If you guys want to do a current gen playbook, I'll go ahead and get the current gen and do some plays and figure out some plays in there as well. The plays are different in current gen for the Bucks than it is in next gen, but this is the next gen Bucks playbook. I'll make sure I put that in the title as well. The next gen Bucks playbook. This is your boy RJ. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment. Until next time, let's get it.